Together, growing in faith, changing communities.
Second reading we heard today. And I want to pose these questions. Have you ever felt like you are trapped in your life? You feel like you are at a dead end. You don't know where to go. You don't know what to do anymore. You see no progress. And you are stuck in one place. You are with the people that you don't want to be with anymore. You do things that no longer makes you happy. Things that are no longer giving you joy. Things that are not helping you to grow. You are stuck in one place. You are stuck with friends who have no future. You tried everything to fix your life, but things are not falling into place. You have qualifications for that job, but there are no opportunities. You are in a relationship, but all you have is accusations, insecurities. All you have is constant apologies. But for some reason, you are still stuck. And you say to yourself, I find myself here, even today. Yesterday I was here, and today I am here. I am stuck. Even at work, you have people. You know that these people don't like you. But every morning you have to go to work, and you are still stuck there. And guess what? The Lord who opened the sea so that the Israelites can walk on the dry land is the Lord that will open the doors for you. The Lord that will make way for you. Even in situations that when people look at and think that it is not possible to walk through, but Jesus who is resurrected can make a way for you. In the book of Exodus, we hear the people of Israel were lamenting to Moses as the Egyptian army were coming. The army was coming and people started to shake, to shiver, and they felt that God had abandoned them. It was better for them if they stayed in Egypt. And they started crying to Moses. They went to Moses and said, Moses, it was better for us when we were still there. Look at these people now, they are following us. And Moses started crying to the Lord. Because when we are faced with difficulties, we start to look back. We look back even in the places where there was pain. And we say, better the pain I knew than the situation I am in right now. Better the place that I was hurt because I knew what was going on and I could endure. But here I am stuck. The people of Israel, they were stuck. They had nowhere to go. All that was there was the sea, and there was no way. And the Egyptian army was coming, was drawing even closer. Now, Moses cries to God, because our God is a God who answers. Our God does not let his people suffer without answering their prayers. It doesn't matter how long God takes, but eventually he answers the prayer. He asks Moses, why are you crying? And he tells Moses, tell the sons of Israel to go forward. To go forward. To move on. To go forward. Sometimes we are progressing in life, and there are things that are following us. The Egyptian army is coming to us. When we make progress in life, there are those people coming behind us. They want to pull us back. They say, come back to Egypt. It was better when we were still in Egypt. But God is saying, tell those people to go forward. The army is coming, but I don't care if there is a sea or the ocean in front of you, but go forward. I would like to say to you today, I would like to say to us today, you see there is an ocean in front of you, and you see no way of crossing over. You see no path of going through. But God says, Noma kunjalo, go forward. Move on. Even when the past is haunting you, don't look at the past. Just go forward. God is saying today, I am leading you. The angel of the Lord was behind the Israelites. It was before the Israelites, and it was in front of the Israelites, so that whoever is coming in front of them, whoever is against the destiny that God wants them to reach, the angel of the Lord may shatter them. Go forward. Regardless of what you have been through, regardless of the pain that you have endured, regardless of the opportunities that you have missed, move forward. Sometimes we feel that we are stuck. Go forward.